obviously Cam Williams, Kata, you know, was in his fourth year. We knew he was a special guy as long as he stayed healthy. And Andrew Dockage gave us a lot more than we even expected. So there's no doubt. We recruit these guys to come in and potentially impact right away. So.
I guess Luther was maybe one of those guys on the road trip to Europe that was more involved than maybe the others. Is he ahead of the rest of them right now?
That's a good question. Obviously, I think a lot's going to be determined come Saturday on. We start playing other people. But I think all four have a chance to cement roles with the team. And I think these games early on, these scrimmages, these exhibitions are going to tell us a lot. But Luther, like Coach, I think, has mentioned to you guys before, he's definitely going to play a good role with us this year.
Losing those guys that you mentioned, the Kata, the Jayshon Tates, have you seen anyone specifically step up into that leadership role in this offseason?
CJ Jackson, for sure, as we expected. He had such a great jump last year, right? And now he's even more secure in who he is as a player, as a person. And he stepped up big. And Andre Weston, he's not always going to be the biggest rah-rah leader in the world. I think you guys recognize that from watching us play. But by example, with his voice in certain spots, I mean, those were two guys who obviously Coach Holtman brought with him to media day, and part of that's because we expect them to have big roles as players, but they've established leadership with our team too. And we got some freshmen aren't afraid, they're not going to defer. Luther, you just mentioned Luther. Some of these guys walking through the door aren't hesitant. You know, we recruited Luther to come in and all these freshmen to come in and help us build a culture. Unfortunately, that culture was built pretty well in year one because of Jayshon Tate and Kata and those guys we mentioned, but all those guys have a chance to step in and kind of lead right away too. It'll be a collective effort with that though.
Have you seen that from Keyshawn Woods as well, just coming in?
Oh yeah, yeah, you can't forget about Keyshawn. Keyshawn's another guy who's not gonna be the biggest rah-rah leader. Like there aren't a lot of them out there anymore, like Jayshon Tate. He was unique, right? So, but Keyshawn is so good at being poised, bringing that experience, pulling guys. Like if you guys watch our practice, and I'm sure you'll see it in games, the amount of times that he pulls guys and shares. And he's an extension. All of our players are an extension of our staff. A point guard is an extension of your staff. Keyshawn, because of his experience, his knowledge of the game certainly is.
What are you most curious to see Saturday out of the guys?
Competitive juice. We're playing a really good team. I thought last year when we scrimmaged, that was like a first step. Like, hey, we can be pretty good. You know, it's one thing when you're hitting each other. It's another when you're hitting another team. So just how much we compete. And we got to be great defensively. Obviously, last year, Kata, Jayshon Tate, we had some established guys who could score the ball. But we were number one defense for the most part last year in the Big Ten. That was a big reason we won. Probably needs to even be a bigger reason, you know, this year. You know, I think scoring, we'll score enough points, but we got to figure that out a little bit better when you don't have Kata and JT at the same time. So defense, our defensive mindset, how we're going to lock in, guard somebody else who's a great program. They're going to hit us first. We got to hit back. Just to see how we react to that.
When you talk about scoring, it seems obvious that CJ and Caleb will probably be your top two scorers. Has anyone sort of stepped up into that third role thus far?
It's to be determined. You know, Keyshawn Woods averaged double digits in ACC, which I think is a heck of a thing, you know, to start. I think it's going to be a really collective approach scoring. I think this year more than ever, we did a great job sharing the ball last year, making the right play. But you had Kata and Jayshon Tate, who could score and had scored at a pretty high level before. I think this year, Caleb Weston's going to be a huge hub for us inside. CJ Jackson showed last year he can score almost 13 a game, but it's going to be collective. It's going to be making the right play, making the right pass, the extra pass, moving the defense, shifting defense, playing off of Caleb, seeing what that opens up with other guys. So it's a little bit to be determined. That's a big question for us, to be honest. So
you were about a month into the practice. Just in general terms, are you happy with where, as a staff, are you guys happy with the progress, everything you've seen? I mean, it's hard to gauge, as you said, until you've teed up against another team, but just, I don't know, do you feel like you've gotten a lot accomplished in a month?
Sure, there's no doubt. We benefited from the summer, too. If you remember the practices, competing in Spain, and I think you're happy this time of year if you're healthy. Mm-hmm. And we're not, you know, no team's ever 100% when you're hitting hard in practice and you're getting after it, but we're close to being healthy, and we have great guys in our program. We have our kind of guys in our program, so we're happy to come to practice every day. They are, too. Got a really family environment here, so it starts there. And we just got to learn more about our team here starting on Saturday. So.